This is the outdoor unit of the inverter mini split air conditioner, and you can see that it has a reactor installed. This is the second outdoor unit, and it also has the same reactor installed. This is the third outdoor unit, and it also has the same reactor. Now, there are three different sizes of reactors placed on the table. These reactors are present in all inverter mini split air conditioners. Often, I have seen that many people refer to this as a transformer. As I mentioned at the start, this is called a reactor. Besides this, I will also explain the method of testing it. So what is this reactor? It works like an inductor. Just like an inductor stores energy in the form of magnetic energy when current flows through it, a reactor also works in the same way as an inductor. And in different units, it is used in different sizes. If the unit is large, the reactor will be large, and if the unit is small, the reactor will be small. It stores magnetic energy and then discharges it. Its main purpose is to filter out harmonics from the current passing through it and allow pure current to enter the system. This ensures the safety of the circuit board, the IPM installed in it, the compressor, and other components in the unit. So this is its main purpose. If it is not installed with the system, these units will deteriorate very quickly and develop faults. These three reactors that you see on the table in different sizes are used in different units. This first reactor is used in units with 4 to 5 amperes. The second reactor is for 8 amperes, and this third one is for 14 amperes. So let me also explain the method to test it. You need to bring a multimeter and set it to the resistance mode. Now I will test this reactor. I will connect both probes of the multimeter to the terminals of the reactor. You can see that the multimeter shows a reading of 0.6 ohms. When the multimeter shows this value, it means that the reactor is perfectly fine and there is no issue with it. Now, I will perform a body short test to check if there is any direct contact between the wires and the body. I will place one probe on one terminal and the other probe on the body of the reactor. You can see that the multimeter does not show any resistance value. I will check the other terminal as well, and here too there is no resistance value shown. This means that the reactor is perfectly fine. You can tell if it is faulty when the resistance value goes from a few ohms up to 200, 500, or 1000 ohms. If the resistance value reaches 1000 ohms, it means that the reactor is completely faulty. Additionally, if the body short test shows a reading when checking with one of the terminals, it also means that the reactor is faulty. Now, I will show you how to test the reactor in this unit. I will first disconnect the wires coming from the circuit board at the terminals of the reactor. After that, I will test it. Just like we checked the resistance across both terminals before, we will test this reactor in the same way. It shows a reading of 0.3 ohms, which is perfectly fine. After that, I will check the body short. I will place one probe on a terminal and the other probe on the copper pipe. The copper pipe gives a good reference. Since no value is shown, it means that this reactor is not grounded. This means that the reactor is perfectly fine. If it were faulty, it would either be grounded or its resistance value would be very high. If you are willing to support the channel, you can buy me coffee. For that, visit Patreon. Click on the left or right thumbnail to watch our next videos. And subscribe. Thank you.